What is up, YouTube? It's your boy Avery here, and I want to make an apology for the last video. I was trying to make a top 10 cards that need to be printed video, and for whatever reason, my mic decided to take a shit on me, so I don't know what happened with that. I do apologize. It should be working now. Y'all know better than me at this point, but I'm going to triple check this fucking video and make sure it actually works. But in apology for that, I decided to cover a deck profile instead. This is King of the Skull Servants with our brand new card, White Baking. We're out here getting waked and baked, and I cannot take credit for this build. That credit goes to, I believe his name is Hang Chow on TCG Player. He's an article writer on there. If I think of it, I'll be sure to leave a link to the story in the description. If not, just type in TCG Player Infinite on your search browser, and you will be able to find this build. He goes very in depth with it and talks about how, you know, this doesn't have to be a 60 card build. This could be a 40 card build, maybe cut down some of the choices down to two copies like Solitaire or Lady in White, White Mare, White Prince, etc. Things like that. So I do consider this just a starting point for the deck. However, in my testing of hands, it does seem very powerful, and it is a going second deck, so you do have that going for you as well. So make sure you subscribe so that you are caught up with all the latest videos that we post. So what is your win con here? Well, of course, it's King of the Skull Servant. Gains 1,000 attack for each Skull Servant in your graveyard, and if when it's destroyed by battle and sent to the grave, you can banish one of the King of the Skull Servants or one Skull Servant from your grave, special summon it, and it also gains 1,000 attack for each King of the Skull Servant in your graveyard. So yeah, that's very cute. You can easily get this thing to 9,000-10,000 attack. They're not going to be popping this by battle. You also have White Baking, which is a new card out of, I believe, Blazing Vortex is the set that we just got. I don't really keep up with a whole lot of sets now, just because to me, Yu-Gi-Oh's kind of been dying because, you know, there's no events. But anyway, White Baking is a level 1 dark zombie monster, 300 attack, 200 defense. That's normal for the Skull Servant monsters. This card's name becomes Skull Servant while in the graveyard. Thank you. If a level 3 or lower zombie monster monsters you control would be destroyed by battle or card effect, you can discard this card instead. If this card is sent to the grave, you can add two monsters with different names from your deck to your hand except White Baking that are either Skull Servant or specifically list Skull Servant in their text, then discard one card. You can only use this effect once per turn. So you ditch this guy, and then once he goes to the grave, you can add White Prince and Skull Servant. You can add Skull Servant Lady in White. I mean, you can get this. You can even get this because it has Skull Servant in the text. Just an overall fantastic card. Yeah, you got to ditch a card, but like you can get White Prince and like say Lady in White, ditch the White Prince and then use its effect to dump one Skull Servant, one Lady in White from your hand and or deck to the grave. So that immediately gives you 3,000 attack points for King of the Skull Servant. And then also, of course, its name is Skull Servant while in the grave. And then you can banish two Skull Servant or Servants, or yeah, two Skull Servants and this card from your grave, especially summon a King of the Skull Servants from your deck. So let's just go ahead and dive into the deck profile. So we're playing a Danger Engine of one Bigfoot, one Chupacabra, three Mothman, one Nessie, one Thunderbird, one Jackalope, one Tsuchinoko, and we're also teching one Doomsday Horde. This card's actually kind of bananas. It came out back in like Phantom Darkness, so we're talking like 2007, 2008. This card's attack and defense are equal to the number of banished dark monsters times 300. We don't give a shit about that. If this card is destroyed and sent to the graveyard, return all banished dark monsters to the graveyard. So you use White Prince, you dump the Skull Servant Lady in White, you banish all three of these, you get out King, he's now at zero, and then if Doomsday Horror is sent in the grave, like let's say off Unizombie or Gozuki or Foolish, then you can dump those three cards back into your grave, giving him 3,000 attack. Or if you pile up more banished Skull Servants, then he can easily become 9,000-10,000 attack. So, very, very good card. We're playing three Gozuki. You can, during the main phase, you can send a zombie monster from your deck to the grave, so it's basically a Foolish Burial. And then if he's sent to the grave, you can banish a zombie monster from your grave, except itself to special summon a zombie monster from their hand. So if you've got plenty of Skull Servants in the grave and this in hand, you can drop this to stop the opponent from killing you in one turn. Playing three King of the Skull Servants, three Mizuki, three Shunrai Solitaire, it's our Lone Fire Blossom. You tribute a zombie monster, special summon a zombie tuner with zero defense from the deck, so you can go for Unizombie. And then if Solitaire is banished, you can target one of your banished Shunrai monsters except itself, or up to two instead if Synthesis is on the field, especially some of them. We don't care about that. This is just a lone fire. You tribute, you get out the Unizombie or any zombie with zero defense and just go to town. We've got three Lady in White. It's just a spell and trap protector, really. Face up level 3 lower zombie monsters on the field, except Lady in White can't be destroyed by battle, and then they are also unaffected by spell and trap card effects. And then its name is, of course, Skull Servant on the grave. So just giving more protection to King the Skull Servants. Two Unizombie, three White Baking, three White Mare. You can target one of your banished Skull Servant or White Mare, return to the grave, or target one of your banished Lady in White or King and Skull Servant special summon it. And you do that just by discarding it. So it's a nice little kind of a hand trap. Three White Prince, and then, of course, three of the Broken Skull Servant. Just best card in the deck. MVP. This is better than Exodia. And then for the spells, we got one Card Destruction, three DDR, one Foolish, three Forbidden Droplet, one Feather Duster, one Jack in the Hand. I don't know how I feel about this card. So you reveal three level one monsters with different names from your deck. Your opponent adds one to their hand. You add one to your hand, and then you shuffle the third into the deck, and you can only activate one per turn. So I don't really know why Cho put this in the deck, because, yeah, you can search, but, like, what are you going to grab? Like, Skull Servant, White Prince, and King of the Skull Servants. Well, the opponent's obviously going to take King of the Skull Servants, and then, like, or they'll take the White Prince, and then you're just left with either Skull Servant or King of the Skull Servants. So I really don't know how I feel about this card. I really don't. One Monster Born, one 1-for-1, three Popper Up, three Unexpected Die, three Where Art Thou, just, you know, control level 1, add a level 1, it's really good. And then one Red Reboot. I really like Popper Up in this deck. If you have like a whole hand of monsters, and then for your 6th card you draw into a Popper Up going second, you can just go Popper Up and ditch your Skull Servant monsters, trigger their effects, and then draw that same number of cards you discarded. You do take 1,000 damage for each card in your hand, but I mean, I'm willing to lose half my life points if it means killing you in one turn. Then we have one Union Carrier, the Busted Underworld Goddess of the Closed World. I really love the artwork on this thing. One Trisbania, one Anima, one Pentastag and Link Karibo, one Link Spider, one Unicorn, Phoenix and Cerberus, one Transversor, one Curious, one Apollosa, one Chaos Ruler, and one Borload Savage Dragon. Let's go ahead and shuffle up some hands here right quick. And we got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So going first, obviously this hand's kind of booty booty butt cheeks. But then if you're going second, you've got the Chupacabra, and so that gives you some other plays. You can Feather Duster the shit out of them. You can go Droplets, ditch the Lady in White and the Chupacabra, triggering the Chupacabra, which, since it was discarded, you get targeted Danger Monster in the grave, so that's kind of irrelevant. oops. But, I mean, who really cares at that point, you know what I mean? You could ditch the DDR and the Lady in White so that the opponent can't use spells or monster effects to respond. You can use the Unexpected Die to get level 4 or lower vanilla, so you can go for the Skull Servant. You can summon this and make a Link play. This is kind of an irrelevant card. So depending on how many monsters the opponent has, you just drop with them and kill them. You summon the Chupacabra, activate this, bring out this, make a Link 2. Yeah, I mean, that's, again, you know, not the best hand in the world. You could do something like Union Carrier, two monsters with the same type or attribute, so they're both dark. That allows you to grab Doomsday Horror. That's typically what you're going to be grabbing with Union Carrier, is just going for the Doomsday Horror and then getting it off the field, whether it be, you know, just destroying the Union Carrier or something and then be able to get its effect. Let's go for one more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So this hand isn't terrible going second. I mean, you use the Unexpected Die to go for the Skull Servant. You have the Gazuki, so you can dump a zombie from your deck to the grave. And then if you can use the Mothman to even just ditch one of these three, and then if they hit the Mothman, okay, fine, whatever, but if they hit one of these, then you're in a nice position, especially if they hit the White Prince, because you're already going to have a White Prince in the grave with this, and this isn't once per turn. So you summon this, dump the White Prince, then you dump a Lady in White and Skull Servant, use the White Prince, use Mothman, hope they hit the White Prince, and then dump another three cards, banish three, get out King of the Skull Servants, he's at 3,000, and then if you can pull off Doomsday Horror into the grave the same turn, then he'll return those three and get this guy to 6,000 attack. So I think it's an interesting concept. I think it's really cool. The way that the TCG Player article writer described it is basically Gren Mazu, but with better search power. And I really agree with that. They're both kind of one and the same in a way. You know, Gren Mazu obviously can gain more attack because of each banished card. Whereas King of the Skull Servant, let's see, his max attack, if both of these are in the grave, then you're looking at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13,000 attack. Yeah, So you better be winning. So let me know what you guys think in the comments below about this deck. Do you think that maybe this has a place in the meta? I really don't know. I'm still sticking with Invoke Dogmatica Shadal myself, but I do love me some Skull Servant. This has always had a special place in my heart. So thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next video.